or a cowboy out here.
I could have done that before I put all the chips in the bag. He was new to this.
That would have been too easy.
Yeah, for real.
Who'd you call out again, Jerome?
Hey, what'd you say, Jerome?
Thanks. I ain't saying it again if you didn't hear it.
I was really quiet. I don't let you do what you
who
are you calling
this
out?
This is the chip draw for the small tire shootout tonight. Impromptu. I think they said they had 28 or 29 cars. This is the chip draw for
you. You want to call out Russ Freeman? Russ Freeman, do you accept? Okay. Anybody else?
Chip draw for the small tire shootout. Impromptu put on by the boys tonight. Jimmy Dale and Poland. Like we've got 29 cars. We had 32 last night. We've got 29 cars tonight after OA's classes get done.
I'm going to go
That dude's wearing me out.
Yeah, the track owner here is a real piece of work.
We need the list again. We're off on chips.
Oh, come on.
So read them from the top and I'll pull them
out. Now let's do it. Lay them all out. Just put them all out. What? Troy, I have no idea. I'm busy at the moment. You were over there fucking with your car and driver's meeting started about 10 minutes ago, buddy.
What did I just got here?
How's it feel to be fresh and showered? And,
yeah.
You know.
I have.
All right, that was silly. Rock Perry. He's out. He's out.
Get the rear tires off.
Back it up. Get the rear tires off. And
take another one. Right?
And just drop the bags out of the segment.
First pair, left lane. Ryan Mitchell. First pair, right lane. Todd Spears.
Hey.
Second pair, left lane.
Ryan Mitchell and Todd Spears.
Troy Mullenberg.
What is it with these Ryans, bro?
Second pair, right lane. Dale Motley. Third pair, left lane. Biederbaum. Third pair, right lane. Terry Thompson. Fourth pair, left lane. Brody Blackwell. Fourth pair, right lane. Ryan Martin. Fifth pair, left lane. Brandon Sandlin. Fifth pair, right lane. Dallas Dillon. Sixth pair, left lane. Brandy Hubbard. Roy Allen. Seventh pair left lane. Barney. Was that eighth pair?
Yeah, because we had to call out.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, eighth pair. Eighth pair right lane is Andy Willoughby. Ninth pair left lane. Brock Perry. Ninth pair right lane. Rankin.
I'll see either one of you.
10th pair left lane. America Trevino. 10 left. 10 right. Aaron Wolf. 11th left. Scott Taylor. 11th right. Triangle Speed Shop.
No way.
That's what you get for staying the next week.
Randy Westmoreland. Club fair right lane. Greg Wilson. What are we on? 13th fair left lane. I need one chip at a time. Put them both back in there. On that 13 left, Jason Horde. 13 right. Marco.
You're going to be doing the burnout. Look up there in both of
14th left. Lance. Kanege. 14th right. Russ Freeman. That's it.
Hey, the pot is $4,200.
How much?
I want to see a show of hands on my truck class. Where are my truck guys at? And gals, excuse me. Okay, I wanted her to be able to see every one of y'all, because she said she's going to fuck every single one of y'all up. I haven't said enough to talk shit. No, but seriously, guys, on the trucks, something's been brought to my attention, and one thing I am is fat, one thing I am not is a cheater. So I'm just not gonna point anybody out, all of y'all. On the trucks, there's been brought to my attention that there's a couple people that don't fit the rules on the tailgate deal. So here's what I'm gonna do, and it's the only fair thing to do. I'm gonna recommend to you, from honesty, again, I am fat, but I'm not a liar. I'm gonna recommend that you don't do this, but if you do, I'm gonna say, I told you so, you're stupid. But we are tech, and there's been a couple deals about the tailgates. I do not have a single rule that says it has to open like the factory. It has to be able to scratch your ass. You can pull a step out of it and have a little handle for a fat ass like me to get in and out. Every tailgate works. If somebody has a problem with one truck, and we all know who it is, there's a couple of them now, it is a $100 bill for you to protest. Every one of you guys are going to get together as a group, and we're going to protest it in front of him, in front of everybody. We're not going to talk shit on the internet. We're not going to do none of that. We're going to do it right here in front of them, but I will tell you, I will double your money that you're going to lose it. You're going to pay that guy that you're protesting before he opens it. Is everybody fair with that? It does not have to open up and lay all the way down. It says functioning, meaning that it will move, whether that's a quarter inch or whether it's 1 inch. I have verified it, and my partner, well, not, she's my partner, he's just my best friend. We have verified it, but I'm telling you, if anybody right now has a problem with anybody's truck, can two or whatever, speak now, don't be a sissy, and it's a $100 bill, and every one of us are going to line up, and you're going to pay that man before he opens and shows you, but I promise you, I'll double your money, you're going to lose your bet. Anybody want to protest?
Just race.
A quarter inch, whatever. Okay, that's all good, I won't say anything. Now, today, we are leaving off of a 4/10 Pro Tree. It is not auto start, it is manual start. Once you go in, if you stage first, it is courtesy staging. You put your first bulb on, wait for him to put his other. If you go in and double, I'm going to try to catch you, but he's not going to go in, and that's going to essentially get you to red light. So, 7 seconds. Once you're in, and you have your, you know, he's in, he goes in on his second bulb, or you go in on yours, 7 seconds later, it's turning on red. So that is...
7 inch. It's 7 or more. I mean, 7. It's not going to be less than 7.
It will time him out, guys. First is worst. If something comes off your car, a door, a wing, or something, and goes in front of that person's lane, you know, that is impeding their race. Any questions so far, guys? Y'all pretty much good at what all goes on here. Anything on the track that one burnout only, water burnout only. Now, on the deal yesterday, we had a lot of people. They were pulling into the water box, and I understand that a lot of people want to do a burnout in the water box, but as you're sitting there, they're pulling outside of it, and when they go to do their burnout, the track is hot, your tires are hot, and then it's dry, and you can't do a burnout. Sit in the water until you're ready to do your burnout, but do not come 10 feet, 20 feet out. I don't have a rule about it, but guys, what we're doing is we're dragging it all the way out, and then it's promoting a problem for everybody else. So just be courteous of everybody.
If you try to do a burnout, you don't make any smoke the first time, something sticks or whatever, you can back up and try again. If you can't do it the second time, just pull up to the light and go home. Okay? That's as simple as that. But if you don't make, but if you do a little bit of a burnout, make a little bit of smoke, that's your burnout, that's it. We're not gonna keep going back and forth.
We're gonna try to run it fast tonight, guys. We've got a band that's gonna be playing here tonight. I understand we're racing, but we're also having a festival at the same time. Me and Tim Williams, a cheater in one of the classes that he races in, we're gonna dance tonight. So your son had me do that. Your son had me do that. I'm sorry, Tim. But guys, is there any question about the racing aspect of it?
Well, we're finishing it tonight.
I'm sorry?
We're finishing the tailgate all the way.
We're finishing everything tonight before you and I dance.
Good.
Any questions, guys? Seriously, on the tailgate got deals. You know, I just want to be fair to everybody, but I'm telling you, as God is my witness, I don't even like Jason Cantu. I don't like the color of his truck. I'm just kidding. He's a good guy. But I've checked every vehicle, guys. If there's a problem, let us know now and let's get over it. That's with any truck. I'm not meaning to call him out. He just has a pink pretty truck. Okay, on the crews, all the crews will come into here, Outlaw Daily, Daily Driver, and True Street. Okay, I didn't know that I had to put it in there, but yes, True Street is making a cruise, guys. Now, it's also been asked that some of the Outlaw Daily tomorrow, we're probably going to end up having to do a small cruise tomorrow because some people couldn't make it here today, and it's only fair. If y'all are making the cruise, they need to make the cruise. I'm not going to require that you make the cruise again if you want to. It's cool. There's people filming it, you know, this and that and everything else, but some of the people that come in tomorrow that were not here today, they're going to have to make the cruise. You know, fair is fair. We're going to leave out of the track. Lloyd, are we going left or straight?
Left.
Okay, we're gonna go left because there's a little bit of road construction across the street right here. It's only another half mile. We're gonna go out, we're gonna turn right, we're gonna follow that highway all the way out. We're gonna go into a town called Purcell. Stoplight, turn right, come down. There's a Tractor Supply on your right-hand side. You're gonna go in there to Lloyd and Wiley. Oh, are you taking your S10?
Yeah.
White S10 and his yellow convertible Fox Body Mustang, I can say. You're gonna go over there and you're gonna get a chip from him. Hey, somebody, we need a Heimlich maneuver over here on a dog.
guys, get a chip. He's right here. Bring that chip back here. It's a blank chip. I'm gonna take your tech cards and we'll prepare those and make sure. But bring in that chip back and sure that you made the cruise.
It's like, is it out?
And then we'll just.
Same place we always go. We stay out of the gravel and the park when we pull out.
Huh?
You go out without driving through the gravel when we pull out.
Well, the only thing is you've got people coming through the gate to pay, unfortunately. Okay. I'm sorry, but I asked if we could get that paved, and to be honest with you, they told me to get fucked.
Right.
Both trucks. However it is labeled on there, I'm sorry, I've got too many. Where's my golf cart? Anybody got that schedule?
I got it.
True Street, Cheap Street, Mod Street.
True,
Mod, Cheap, Large Truck, Small Truck,
Fire.
Got it?
Now, anybody? If anybody is in small tire, we are going to change things up a little bit again. For the fans that are here, if y'all want to do a grudge tonight, we're probably going to do two rounds. So we're going to go about two or three rounds of, you know, our classes today. And then we're going to bring in one round for the fans where they can get a, it doesn't matter because we're going to tear apart the track again tomorrow. But we're going to do one round of grudge tonight, no singles grudge. And then later on in the evening, before we shut it down, we're going to do one more round. So if anybody is in truck that's in small or vice versa, anything else, just letting you guys know, okay?
We want to be legit at grudge, though. We don't want a small tire car against the damn daily driver. I mean, have a legit grudge race. If you want a True Street, y'all are all really small tire. We know that. There's all around small tire car. That's okay. But, no, I mean, make it something that's actually relatable to the people watching the race. That's why we're doing the race.
Now,
yes. You got two questions.
It was small tire. Now, because, I mean, testing was last night. Yeah, small tire right now. Small tire right now. Just, I don't know how time's going to allow. I'm sorry. If we're running good, then I'd say let's put on a show for the fans. That's why we're here, you know. Who else had a question?
I just want to make sure it's out there. As long as you're still in, you can't grudge race.
That's correct. You'll wait for the later in the night if you're in small tire.
Yes, sir. Yeah, once you're out, yeah, then once you can
you're
grudge out. Race.
Yeah, once you're a loser.
No grudge race in between your competition.
Now, besides this 10-foot tall woman over here talking shit to any other truck out there, she was, don't let that pretty smile. Mm-hmm. I also heard from another young man over here that he said, hey, nobody got the first balls to call him out at old Beetlejuice. Ain't nobody. I'm just saying, I don't know what it is about not being 6 foot tall, but they're mouthy. Damn it, they're mouthy.
I'll put on 16.
Cheap Street guys, I know that we've run everything. You know, we are at Al Armageddon, but all final decisions will be made by me. You don't come talk to Mark or his baby mom or any other stuff and say what she said. Any and all decisions about rules or something, whatever, we're going to go along their rules, but anything, final decision, no sweet. We are going to do chip draw just like everything else. I'm probably going to sweet talk the ladies over here to also chip draw for us as well. If not, I'll do it. But once we're done here with Travis Bean, Cheese Street, we hang out, we'll draw the index.
Is everybody paid for Cheap Street?
Yeah.
Okay. Fair, are we getting our test hit like normal?
No, it's going to be off the trailer. No preps are always off the trailer.
Okay. One thing that did happen last night, guys, the app and everything is removed from the tower. There is absolutely no way that we can tell or show what you're running. But last night, we said in the driver's meeting, nobody go to that second floor. It is locked, and there is a police officer on the inside of that door. For y'all's timing protection, it is what it is. I don't want anybody in that tower. I myself cannot get in there, okay? So we had about 7 people last night go to knocking on that door. They're not gonna open the door for you. So in case there's an emergency, go somewhere else. Do not go to that second floor tower because they've been given strict instructions. Nobody will know their time or nobody will see your time. So I'm sorry, but that was the rules that you all wanted and that's the rules that are enforced. So is there any questions, guys? I know we're kind of dropping it all on you, but, and all the crews, if y'all see a Sonic, could I get a 44 unsweet iced tea with lemon, please? I'll pay extra.
Safety gear. I'll come up here in shorts, flip-flops, and stuff like that. That's
you'll be disqualified.
Really?
Safety gear. Yeah. Even
Wiley. I found out. It's true.
It's
for your own safety, guys. If y'all have safety gear, literally.
It was first round.
Myself and our whole crew, guys, we're going to be looking in there just because that's our job. But if you're trying to hide it, literally, I'm going to step in front of your car, man, and I'm going to let the other guy go just because he's not going to wait for you. I know there's a lot of guys.
Don't have your pit crew open the door so they can see you in shorts.
That don't have gloves on, I get it. But if you have your safety deal, please, guys, wear it. But do not come up here with a t-shirt and shorts and your thong. It's not going to be accepted. No pun intended. So,
what's that?
Yeah, let's talk about that.
Yes, but if you would, get up here immediately so we can get the chips and everything. I understand if y'all come in, but please get back here immediately, right?
Yeah. Bring the chips back. They're going to be right there at the base of the tower. You can come right up that sidewalk and drop the chip off between. Give them your name and give them your car. It makes it a lot easier for them if they know what the car is to make sure they're paired with it. That's the other thing, guys. We don't have enough crew to make sure that you guys are paired up with who you're supposed to be paired up with. If you don't know them, ask the question, find out who it is, make sure you're paired up with the right person. Once you get up there, we're not going to be able to police it if you're not. We're just going to run whoever's next to each other. We're going to call them in. We don't have enough people and enough staff to do it. So make sure you know who your race is. Get close to them. Get with them in the back lane, whatever you got to do.
1 hour from the time you leave to the time you get
right. And then once the chips are, once the pairings are drawn, they'll be posted to the glass on the south side of the tower. Everybody go up there and take a picture of whatever you want to do. Get your chip up there. Get your chip out here. We saw drawing parents. You're out. We want to see if you make the cruise.
My wife,
Heather, and Destiny will be up there doing all the chips. So just don't have the table there like you do every year right here.
Any questions, guys?
On the cruise, like last year, we let a bunch of people take their hoods off and stuff.
Okay, so, yes, good question. A lot of people were asking about True Street. For the spirit of it, it would be awesome to have it on there. And there's no written law in Oklahoma that states that you have to have a hood. I'm going to be lenient. I'm just going to say, guys, do what you want on that. I don't really care. I mean, it's kind of cool seeing a. If I'm driving down the road and I see somebody with no hood on, I'm going to slow down and sit there and look at it. But, you know, in the spirit of the class, if you have it, you want to put it on there, please do. But if you don't, you don't.
But it was awesome.
Any questions, guys?
Trips
after every round?
Every round we'll draw chips,
yes. Yeah. Okay. All right. Okay, are we coming back up there if we win, draw chips again, or
draw chips
again?
You don't have to be there.
Once you're in the system, we separate winners, losers, and just move through.
Do we come back up there to draw chips?
Nope. Automatic draw. We usually just pick somebody random to draw. Okay.
Your name will be on a chip.
Yeah.
Chip.
We just randomly, yeah. We've actually been trying to find little kids. to come and pull the chip. So get the crowd involved.
All right, True Street only. I need your tech card.
True Street only, tech cards. Right.
Thank you. Hey! True Street, round number three. I need you to the lane, guys. True Street, round number three. I need you to the lane.
All right, folks, round two drawings coming up for the small.
Ready?
Right now.
First pair, left lane. Ryan Mitchell.
Ryan Mitchell, first pair, left lane.
First pair, right lane.
I can't believe Terry didn't win.
Come on, Bill. Come on. Rankin.
Rankin and Mitchell, first round.
Second pair, left lane. Ryan Martin.
Ryan Martin, left lane, second pair.
Versus Jason Rank, right lane.
Jason Rank.
Third pair, left lane. Beater Bomb.
Beater Bomb, left lane, third pair.
Third pair, right lane. Varney.
Varney, Beater Bomb versus Varney.
Fourth pair, left lane. Brandon Sandlin.
Sandlin, fourth pair, left lane.
Fourth pair, right lane. Jason Horde.
Jason Horde versus Sandlin.
Troy Mullenberg.
Mullenberg, left lane.
Versus Randy Westmoreland, seventh pair, right lane.
Randy Westmoreland.
I didn't say seventh pair. Fifth pair, right lane.
Right.
Sorry. There's seven pairs total, so that's kind of hard. Sixth pair, left lane.
There he is.
Lance Kanigi.
Kanigi.
There.
Six pair right lane.
You got to feed the starting line guy. Aaron, you can't just leave him up there for 3 days and not feed the man.
What do we got?
Last and final pair. Left lane, Brandy Hubbard.
Come on, who's it gonna be?
Versus Triangle Speed Shop.
All right.
I do this for nothing.
Well, no, I just came. Yeah, you said I'll meet you at the trailer to do chips.
Yeah.
blew off the truck. Oh man. Got a 7-amp.
Done.
Street for the safety lane. Keep Street for the safety lane. Big truck be on standby. All right, our small tire shootout. I need you to be.
Thank you. truck category. Here's what we got left. Jason Sanchez, Henry Jones, and Matt Burrow down by the field. A three.
Jeff Custis down to Ranger 15 full size truck final round.
Hey, what's the fuck up for
I feel like something's wrong.
down here.
No, I won that down there.
Hey, here's Todd. Have some fun, right?
I got great cars.
Just taking y'all.
this thing.
Yeah.
T-Max, Firebird versus Mustang. Way to send it off. All right, see you guys tomorrow.